G'day all, Mr. Paladin here. And in past videos, I have talked frequently about having a main class. But I think some people are taking that message the wrong way. Listen, the purpose of having a main class is strictly a learning tool. When you are starting the game, it can be extremely overwhelming because you are trying to identify if the person you are looking at is simply an enemy or not. The experienced player is already trying to work out what they are doing based on the items they are holding and even the loadout that their enemy is using. Just at a glance, they can see what's coming and they know how to handle the situation because they know the loadout that their enemy is using just as well as their own loadouts. Now, while I could go on and tell you that you should be looking at the weapons and classes the enemy is using, a new player just can't go there yet. They don't know what they're looking at. So I'm talking to the new players when I'm talking about maining a class. You have stepped into the game fresh, and you don't know anything, and you have played a few of the classes, and you know only the ones that you enjoy, or the ones that are interesting to you. The ones that you are finding fun to play. At this point, I would encourage you to pick a main. Not because only playing one class is beneficial, but because you want to take some time to focus on a few things. I want the new player to concentrate on their own skills and their own weapons for some time. While eventually you will understand the pros and the cons of every class, the pros and the cons of every weapon, the pros and the cons of the maps you're on, you first have to start somewhere. So starting with your class's main strengths and weaknesses, it's vital to get a grasp on what your favorites can and cannot do. You need to understand that your soldier, you may want to bring a direct hit versus an enemy sentry gun, or that your medic may want to switch to a Kritzkrieg because the enemy team's medic is using a quick fix. Or maybe you want the Krieg because you're on defense and your team is loaded up with soldiers and demo men. Or that your engineer may want to switch off of that wrench to a gunslinger because of the number of enemy spies. Or as a spy, it might be time to switch from a dead ringer to an invis watch. This kind of stuff you learn as you start maining a class. Choosing and playing a main will give you this focus, to let you know the basics of a particular class. But you won't master a class until you start branching out after this. But don't do that straight away either. You know, unless you're getting bored, maybe the class you thought was going to be your main just isn't gelling for you, the mechanics just aren't right, you made a bad choice, so, you know, picking a new main is perfectly fine and do it at will. But you may have learnt, hey, I thought the engineer would be fun, but you know what, I hate camping out in a nest. And I see that my teammates don't think about me and help me when I'm trying to move that gear up. Or perhaps you're playing a medic and healing people, but you find it's frustrating because teammates are just not hitting targets no matter how much health they have or how much criticals you give them. Or perhaps you started maining spy like me, because you saw this really cool gentleman online and you thought it would be fun playing it. But the more you played it, you just got frustrated because of all the technicalities that enemies were able to spot you for and kill you. So switch your main. Find the one that you enjoy. Picking a main is only a learning tool. And it is only a learning tool for a few people. It may not even be the thing that helps you learn. I just find it's best in the most number of cases. After you have a main, you are comfortable with your class skills and loadouts, I want you to start learning about different maps and positioning. Learn how the map flows, and when your class main is the most effective on that map. You'll see these clips, I'm playing an engineer. Not my main, of course, and we will get to that. But I'm using my experiences on this map to decide when and where I move my gear, where I put my teleporters, etc, etc. And even if I die, I'm supporting the team, keeping that payload either moving or well defended. Learning maps takes a long time, and there are still tricks about some maps that I either find by accident, or I'm watching someone else's clips and pick up a trick or two. So here we are. You now have a main, who you are confident about, you're having fun with it. You know your loadouts, you know all of its pros and cons. You know the flow of the common maps, and now you start branching out. When you start seeing enemies, I want you to not only see their class, I want you to start seeing their loadouts. I want you to start to understand what your opponent's strengths and weaknesses are when you come up against them in a one-on-one situation. Are you an engineer, but the enemy soldier is using a cow mangler? Well, you know that his weapon is weak to you and your sentry gun, but you do know that he could disable your gun with a powered shot. You also pick up that he's not going to be getting much use out of the enemy's Kritzkrieg. Are you a spy, but the enemy sniper has a Razorback? He's going to behave a lot differently to the sniper who's holding a Jurate. There's a big problem with learning this step, and quite often, you don't know the strengths and weaknesses until you've tried playing them. So at this point in using your main, I want you to start playing other classes. Start having fun, branching out, playing the classes that you might feel a little bit uncomfortable with. Because the best way to learn a class's strengths and weaknesses is to use them for just a little while. Dabble around with these classes and loadouts. Heck, you can even check my own profile. I have plenty of hours even in my least played classes of Sniper and Scout. I do not enjoy playing Sniper or Scout. I just don't like both of those classes' mechanics. I'm not a big fan of standing back and getting headshots behind my team. I'm not a huge fan of quick scoping or hard scoping, or getting into a battle with the enemy sniper. It's just not in me. Or as a scout, I don't like getting around the battlefield in the way a scout does. I don't like playing the floor is lava. It's just not my thing. Now, I appreciate the people who have those as their class mains and are really good at them. I do like that. But it's just not in me to do it. I do not have fun playing those classes. Just like those two, I'm not overly fond of playing Demo Man or Heavy. Now, I don't mind playing those two classes if the team needs one. I understand the positions that a Heavy needs to get in and how he needs to work with his Medic, or how to best use the spammy Demo Man-y. But I don't enjoy them as much as the other classes that are my off classes. If I can't play Spy, I quite enjoy playing Soldier, Medic, or even Engineer like in this clip. While still not as good as my main, I can easily fill the role that the class plays for the team across any map with a mix of loadouts. They are fun to play and I enjoy playing them. So yes, I think as a learning tool, people should have a main. But the more hours you play in a game, you should branch out to have a selection of off-classes that are just a list of your favorites. Only use class mains as a learning tool. Don't go stacking classes, but be useful to your team. Feel free to change your class main on a whim, and nobody will hold it against you. If one day a nerf comes along that is too harsh for you, that you no longer have fun with the class, change your main. Go ahead. No one demands that you play a game in a particular way. So while I have many videos about class mains, or even my own children picking their class mains, this is only to help them in learning the game. Both OmegaBot and Goblin King have changed their mains, and they will change them again as they are learning more about the game. They are understanding how the classes interact, and they are learning the nuances between the loadouts, and they are finding things that are more fun for them, and only using a class main as a tool or mechanic for learning the whole game. Welcome to Team Fortress 2. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors.
Non più tre farfalloni amoroso, notte giorno di torno girano, delle belle turbando a riposo, ma ci sento a doncino d'amore.